So we'll be here on the fake patient list, of course, with very long times because they were started. Stevens, this is your test patient here. And this is the new added thing, document. And right now we don't have that, but they're going to turn it on that day. And you're going to click document, and it's going to bring up the list of possible templates. You will, somebody's already done Alterman status or allergic reaction, but we're going to start a new one. And what would you like to do? Headache.
Abdominal pain.
Abdominal pain. So you could select from one of those, or you can start typing abdominal pain, and then let's say this is over 40. And the reason it's different, you know, just like this system, they have some other required fields that doesn't. The first thing you got to do, and actually this is probably the most important part, is confirm the patient. If you start documenting on the wrong patient and you end up saving it, there's no way to delete it. So if you started writing ankle sprain on a altermental status and you saved it, it's going to be there, and you're going to have to write a big note explaining that this is not the right patient. So confirm patient, yes, this is Stevens. And then your menu, you'll go to OK Next. This is the way to move the menu because it'll prompt you the next required step. So we're seeing the patient now. Or you could have gone back and say, no, we actually saw him a half an hour ago, so I'm going to change that. And then you can just write whatever.
Okay.
PCP, you can just skip through it if you don't want to. Transfer from nothing, doesn't matter. So the ones that have the asterisk are going to be required fields. You have to do those before you sign. But the computer is smart enough to tell you you can't sign the chart if you haven't done it. So chief complaint is abdominal pain, but also nausea, vomiting. And source history is the patient. You know, it just you would just move through it. Mm-hmm. Okay, next, arrived by ambulance, sure. And that one pre-populated probably because the nurses had already put it in. Timing and onset, sudden, yesterday. And essentially, you just move through the menus. You just have to learn to look. It's been going on one day. Okay, next. Pain location, epigastric. Quality, sharp, and stabbing. Radiation to the back. Severity, you know, 8 or severe or whatever. So essentially, just keep moving through the menus. Now, when you do something like this, you could actually do denies all. Of course, I don't recommend that. You do your first, do your positives. So, for example, constipation, no. Let's say hematemesis, yes. Nausea, yes. And that's it. So you could have done the positives first, for example. No. Now it won't let it. But if you would have done that first and then move the negatives or the other way around. But abdominal pain, see, you come up negative, and we would have contradicted because it's here for belly pain. So we got to make sure that we get it right because you'll end up having contradiction. So the danger of doing a hand click is that you end up with incongruences in your chart. But then we're going to move to OK next. Anytime, it always lets you do free text. You know, it will always let you say more. Patient was just in the ED yesterday with same, but was not vomiting blood. The blood, you know, you can always free text anything, blah, blah, blah. Okay, next. Spontaneous. Pregnancy doesn't matter. Context history. You can move through. And the problem with this charting, which is also the benefit, is that it'll prompt you so many things that you'll end up documenting things you would have not normally documented. Like, we normally wouldn't have wrote this, but now since it's here, well, yeah, he's had history of pancreatitis. He's had kidney stone. Sexual history, I don't really care about that. But you just move through. But those are not required, so you don't really have to do it. Relieved by nothing. And then I want to make a comment because he had prescriptions. Patient did take Sofran and Miracle with that. Really. So maybe I wouldn't have written that on the actual T system, but because it's here, it's so nice and easy. So anytime you have something you really want to type into, you click the blank one, and it'll pull the menu. Or if you wait to the very end, additional history, you can always free text there. So that's it for the HBI, and then you move through the different parts of the chart over here on these tabs. So risk factors, because it's abdominal, you have to do the AAA because it's more than 40 years old, so that's a required field. Risk factors reviewed as hypertension, and that's it. Ectopic risk factors do not apply because, well, it's a female, I guess. I didn't realize that, but let's say none. And that's it. Okay, next. And now it's going to send you right to review systems. Now, you know that for the most part, you could just go to all systems reviewed and otherwise negative. And you can, I would make it a habit to make that your first field. And then you can always go back and do the pertinence. For example, the pertinence on this would be gastrointestinal, for sure. So nausea, yes. Vomiting, yes. Constipation, no. Diarrhea, abdominal pain, yes. Melanin, no. Hematemesis, yes. No, yes. And then you might want to do fever, for example. So constitutional, no fever, no chills. Yes, malaise. Yes, fatigue. No. And so you do the ones that you want to do, but remember all others negative as marked, you'll be fine. Past medical history. Now this is the cool part. This is where the software actually gets good. These are all already pre-filled because the nurse already did it. So it says no past medical history, no surgical history, denies, blah, blah, blah. And if this patient's never been here before, but now all of a sudden they're here, and this is a repeat visit, everything from the last visit that you documented will be here already. Social, surgical, medications, allergies, so you don't have to do that again.
And you don't have to do anything to make it a part of that chart. It's just populated.
It populates automatically if they've been here before. Okay. If they've never been here before and you wait for the nurses to do their part, then you will have those things in there. Okay. But if you go before the nurse, then you'll be there to it. They won't be there. But once they do, it will populate. So that's really cool. So social history is already there. Past family, it's already there. That's none of the above. I would still go through it and confirm the ones I really care about. But for the most part, that's it. I mean, if you wanted to do occupation, ambulatory status, you know, independent, whatever. So physical exam, there is such thing as a normal exam, and you can do a basic physical, and you can click all of them, normal. I wouldn't recommend doing that, obviously. You want to always do the required elements first, but when you do data formats, that'll import. So vital signs here, you could free text the ones you care about, or you could do data formats, and then you can do vital signs for the last 24 hours. And that will insert all the vital signs for the last 24 hours into your chart. You don't have to put them in. So that's really cool. Vital signs reviewed, yes, okay, next. And then you'll start doing your exam. Anything above this double line is normals. Anything down here is abnormal. It's not like T-system when you can click note obese.
Right.
You just, you can't do that. So you would have to handwrite in your comment or right here on your empty one. You can write whatever you want. But essentially, we're going to move through like normals. So we're going to do alert, nothing. And this is why I said the iPad's not going to work out, because you're going to be tapping a really small screen, and you're going to be using the mouse quite a bit. And then general, so head and eye. See, that's not a required field, so we move to cardiovascular required field. And if you click that, it will even put the negatives on. That's why you can't really do that. So I'm just going to go through my positives. Abdominal, you know, no, blah, blah, blah. So this is easy. You know how to move through that. Procedures, that you have abscess, ankle dislocation, everything. And once you click on that, it'll break it through different things and what you should be filling out. So it's really, really nice. Everything's there. You just click in yes or no, blah, blah. When we get to interpretations and diagnosis, you can do the same thing. Data formats, all ED orders in the last 72 hours. So that'll import the list of all the orders you put into that system. So that's really, really cool.
Glad to see you.
Well, this patient's not going to have any.
Right, no, but if I hit the data...
It'll you'll see it right there.
Are you technically gone? Ring one. after we gave her all the medicines or whatever we gave her, we got her up to go home in the wheelchair, and she's vomiting. And I just wondered
if she's okay. That's fine.
And this is where you really add on to your medical decision making when you actually interpret your results. You click lab interpretation, labs reviewed, you know, and you could click H1 or accept and whatever. Now, when you do the input, it will bring him in. But for medical decision making, you have to interpret that abnormal study.
Right.
So you could do your analysis. You had reviewed positive blood, positive ketones. The results of positive blood and positive ketone will already be in the chart. But if you don't do this, you haven't interpreted the result.
Correct.
So pregnancy testing, so you just move through, you did an EKG and you put your interpretation, your chest x-ray, and you can actually go through, was it radiologist, was it me, you know, was it maybe another doctor, discuss with if you did, in general, no. I mean, you just move through it. In medical decision making, this is where you do your differential diagnosis. There's one right here. And you do, we consider AAA, we considered appendicitis, we considered dissection, and so on and so on. And this, I've never filled this in any chart, but pertinent findings, presentation, acute, history, it's kind of like summarizing again what you did. Severity, this seems like non-life threatening because we end up dying of gastritis. And diagnosis seems clear, evident if you have a definitive diagnosis, but it could be minor, mild, or whatever. And the final dispo, clinical impression. You always have to have a main clinical impression. So somebody clicked dementia already. I'm going to unclick that. I'm going to click all. I want to see all possibles. So I want abdominal pain, non-specific abdominal pain, and I'm going to make it okay next. So now when I go back to primary impression, this is my primary diagnosis, but I also want to do a secondary diagnosis of gastritis. So acute gastritis.